Thank you very much for your kind introduction and good afternoon, everyone. I would like to present my topic that about I'm not nothing to declare about the disclosure. That you know, you learn every topic from the morning to now, like as the art of war. By Sun Wu, if you know your patients, if you know your about the hernia and you know yourself, you can win about the hernia repair and it make the prevention of the hernia. For the prevention of the hernia, I think is have the two topics. One is the primary prevention. And second is the prevention of the recurrent hernia. That the last is important for our surgeon. What you know about the prevention of the hernia, I think anatomy is the important. Some speaker that show you many beautiful dissection of the inguinal area, like as Dr. Suthep, Dr. Wallabut and Dr. Pianan that show you different kind of the techniques that demonstrate the good inguinal hernia anatomy. Second, you choose to know the cause of the hernia pathophysiology and it's extend to the risk factor. And the last one is the your techniques that provide to the patients that many kind of the surgery that you learn from the morning. The first one is the anatomy. Anatomy is the for the abdominal wall, include the inguinal, is the complex muscular layer and is the dynamics. When you standing, walking, running, every activity, use your abdominal wall muscle. So that if you know that, you can, is the key to success for the your hernia repair. But I don't get in deep for this topic because maybe limit time that we really late for this part. Second, the pathophysiology for the inguinal hernia, you can see that maybe caused from the weakness of the connective tissue, thinning of the skin and soft tissue, and stretching. So that you come back go to is the risk factor that cause of the primary inguinal hernia. And the second is the incisional hernia, is ventral hernia. Ventral hernia and the incisional hernia is the come from the wound healing problem and the fascial defect that may be occur when you repair your abdominal wall. So that if you see and you know about the risk factor that from the previous two slides, you can prevent it to the primary hernia and recurrent hernia. So that this, if you control this risk factor, you can overcome the this. For the evidence that report in the international guideline have the risk factor of the inguinal hernia, both of this have the level of the evidence, and both of this you can see some factor is the intrinsic, like at the sex, age, that inheritance that is difficult to adapt it. But some evidence is the extra acquired factor or the another factor that you can control it, like as the pulmonary disease, chronic cough, that you can treat it before the surgery. And for the risk factor of the recurrent hernia that report in the international guideline, same as this one, is the intrinsic factor, some intrinsic factor and some of the acquired factor that you can control it. But for the ventral hernia, risk factor for the primary ventral hernia, know that about the level of evidence report in the study. But for the risk factor for the recurrent incisional hernia can divide in the patient factor type of the surgery and surgical factor, including the surgical site infection like as this, so that this part you can try to control it before or after the surgery. But I think from the morning that you learn from everyone, you can learn about the technique. The proper surgical technique is the key for our surgeon to overcome in the topic of the prevent hernia. So include that the report in the international guideline that show poor surgical technique and not use the proper hernia material, include the mesh and mesh fixation that you learn from the Dr. Pawan, Dr. From the previous that you can like as the Dr. Vimal show the mesh overlap like as this problem that if you not use the proper surgical technique may be cause of the recurrent hernia. So that how do I achieve the surgical technique? The first one, you must learn the get the knowledge and expertise from the expert like as the today, and choose the appropriate approach for the patients and choose the patient's appropriate the hernia material. And the mesh material, pore size, lightweight versus the heavyweight that you learn from the previous lecturer and Ajahn Sathyan that talk about this in the update guideline. Appropriate mesh that for the inguinal hernia, we usually use this number is the report in the this study. Use 15 to 9 for the open hernia and use 15 by 10 by in the laparoscopic or robotic inguinal hernia. That this is my study in the cadaveric Thai patients. We try to measure about the hernia MPO dimensions, and this study showed that 15 by 10 centimeter is enough to cover the MPO dimension in Thai patient. And for the mesh overlap that Dr. Pawan presented before, I think depend on your using the ratio about the mesh and the hernia defect, or use the appropriate more than 5 centimeter to cover the hernia defects. And another one in the prevent of the incisional hernia, for the last for the present recent evidence, the small bite technique is the good way to prevent the incisional hernia. Small bite is mean use the small bites and not tension. Use the slow absorbable suture, and the small bite technique depend on your suture length and the wound in the ratio at least 4:1. This is a different state of the small bite versus the in the past that use a big bite for abnormal culture that may be cause of the ischemia and some more tension that cause of the recurrence. This is a one study that demonstrated by systematic and meta-analysis that show you about the benefits of the small bite versus the large bite stitch technique. And you see the important outcome is the prevent of the incisional hernia that the favor of the small bite more than the large bite technique. And another way that present used for the prevent the incisional hernia is the mesh augmentation. The mesh augmentation, this is a last meta-analysis that to identify the between about the mesh or no mesh in the both elective and emergency surgery. That demonstrate that mesh augmentation have the good outcome more than the no mesh in both emergency and elective surgery. And this is another outcome that about the if you use the mesh augmentation to prevent the incisional hernia, the outcome is significant with the odds ratio 0.45, and the area that you try to use the mesh is the on layer, sub layer. Identify that on layer is the good benefit versus the primary suture closure. However, the sub layer is not significant. And this is our public about the if you tie to mesh augmentation, the mesh good mesh position for this for the in the mesh augmentation for the incisional hernia repair, we conduct by using the seismic review and network meta-analysis. And you can demonstrate that on layer mesh was and lectolectus muscle layer is have the more benefits in the incisional hernia prevention. However, another area may be not significant. And we try to perform more by compare with the lowest hernia incisional hernia occurrence versus the complication. You can see lectolectus muscle area is the good way to challenge for the prevent of the hernia and lowest of the complication like as the seroma infection and hematoma. So that I would like to conclude that how to prevent the hernia. The first one, you should learn not only the one technique for the hernia repair, you should learn every technique that you can select for the patient. Include that, you should learn anatomy, pathophysiology, and clear the risk factor for the patients. Select the proper technique and appropriate hernia material. Thank you very much.
Thank you.